Hello everyone, I am so sorry that I could not upload every day because I am really busy with my exam these days. But I made a point to come back and film this lecture for you. So today we will be talking about J.M. Synge's Playboy of the Western World. But before moving ahead, if you will like this video and if you like the way of my teaching, make sure to hit that subscribe button and also like this video if you really liked it, and share your feedback with me in the comments section. So let's move. So J.M. Synge, he is mainly known for as a postmodern writer, and he is also known for the Irish Renaissance, because with Sean O'Casey and J.M. Synge, they have really revived the culture and literature of Ireland after W.B. Yeats. So we will see that he has written this Gaelic League, taken part in the Gaelic League 1893, and this is the Irish theatre movement. And in this movement, J.M. Synge has written this play, this particular play, which is the Playboy of the Western World. So we will be taking that only. So let us move forward towards the play, Playboy of the Western World. So if I would tell you that the word playboy, it is not used as it is used today, because that time playboy meant which meant it is a very a guy who is always joyful, or who is always cheerful, and fun loving boy. So that is that was the meaning that time of the playboy. But at this time, playboy means something else. So here we will see that there is he will be glorifying the parricide. Parricide is the killing of one's father. In the story, we will see that. So, giving you a bit of introduction. So now we will see. This is set in County Galway, located on the western coast of the province of Connacht. We will see that there is a young man named Christy Mahon. He is the main protagonist of the play, and he arrives as a fugitive from the police, claiming that he has killed his father. And this was glorified in a way that when he went to this place, he was taken as someone who is very brave, who has opposed his father and killed him, because his father was not a good person. Anyways, if we read this play in today's context, especially in Indian context, we will see that killing one's parents is really not a good thing, but this was considered a good thing in this play, because mainly getting relief from his father and the crimes which his father did, according to Christy Mahon, that was really brave and something which is very rare to see at those times also. The peasants, they really like to hear this story and they make him a hero. And if we know, like today as well, if you yourself observe this thing, that if you talk about your unusual story to farmers or workers, they are really interested in knowing you. Even if I tell a story to my student about my life, so he or she will be really interested in knowing my story. So this is what happened, and they made this person a hero. And there is a barmaid whose name is Piggin Mike, the daughter of barkeeper Flattery, and she falls for him. And but mind you, she already had a fiancé whose name is Sean, but she definitely was not loved with Sean. She really loved Christy Mahon for his braveness, chivalry, so-called chivalry, and something which is undone. So as we all know, that something which is undone, which a person cannot do, and if suddenly someone comes and does that same thing, so he or she becomes the hero or prime focus of some country or town. That's what happened here. And this girl Piggin, she fell for this person, Christy Mahon, and she even renounced her engagement with her fiancé, Sean. But this so happened that all of a sudden, Christy Mohan's father, he appeared, and now he says that it is Christy who tries to kill him a second time, but he fails. So now we see that this was very unfortunate for Christy that his father appeared here with police, of course. And we see that Christy
initially also, like once more, he tried to kill his father, which is something considered as a heinous crime. And Christie was the one who was not moral, and he was the one who was doing bad things, and his father just wanted him to be on the good track, but instead of being on the right track, he tried to kill his father. So now what happened, like this, whatever he has done, his misdeeds is now being exposed to the villagers, and they now really hate him because this is considered to be a heinous crime to kill one's parents. And his father was a good man. Everybody notices it. Now Christie loses the heroic aura and is shunned by all, even Piggin. Piggin also leaves him, and he leaves with his father, and both of them, they just went on. And Piggin refuses Sean's offer of marriage. Like, Sean was hoping that now Christie has gone, so Piggin will marry him, but she renounced the marriage also, and says, and everybody is feeling the loss of the playboy of the Western world. So this is how the play ends, and this was very funny to see that the storyline is really nothing. If you see, it is just based on the cultures which one is getting from the Western world. So this is what is about the story. I hope you liked the summary, and let me know in the comments what you think about it. And thank you so much for your feedback, and whatever you guys are saying, I'm keeping this in mind. And yeah, I will see you in another lecture.